I'm curious about new things. My training is scientific training, understanding data and how to interpret data. I think there's pretty compelling evidence that what we do is having an impact on the environment. And part of that is the kind of vehicles that we drive.
That's just one of the reasons Professor Randy Dunham decided to get an electric vehicle.
It drives great, is quiet. The EPA rates it at 238 miles. I've been going 250 to 300 on a charge. I love it.
You have different modes you can change in a vehicle.
Well, right now, I think we're at the turn for electric vehicles. I would definitely have a huge interest in those vehicles. It's still relatively new for a lot of consumers. Where am I going to charge this vehicle is usually a big question you get.
We really want to make it simple to get a level 2 charger installed.
With MG&E's pilot program, Charge at Home, EV owners can get a faster charger at home with no upfront cost.
As soon as I knew I was going to have a Bolt, that was when I signed up for the MG&E program.
It's a 5-year commitment, and for a fixed fee each month, they get the charger installed.
MG&E has covered the cost of installation, covered the cost of the charger.
If there's technical difficulties, we'll take care of it. These chargers are smart chargers, so it actually hooks onto your Wi-Fi network.
If I wanted to, I could use my phone to decide when to charge my car. I can monitor my electric use and the impact that's having on the environment. And MG&E can do that also, and I've given them access to that by participating in this program.
We want to gain knowledge of how long they're plugged in, when they plug it in,
so they can learn. I'm a researcher. When we do research, we are always talking about, let's get all the data we can.
We're going to use that information to help build this industry. This electric car represents a big load for a home.
You get 5 or 6 cars on the same transformer, the bigger load, and that's a concern for the utilities.
The last thing we want is to have some of our equipment get overloaded because we didn't know what was going on out there. We want to be able to more intelligently manage the grid to handle that load.
For me, the future is heading towards the electric market.
That utility getting ready is adapting to changes.
You're going to see electric market kind of blow up across the spectrum, from not only just from cars and hatchbacks, but you're going to see trucks, SUVs are out there now.
I think it's a pretty safe prediction that the traditional internal combustion engine only vehicle is not the future.
People believe that 2020, 2025 is a cusp when electric vehicle technology will be cost parity with owning and operating a gasoline vehicle.
I've never been called a tree hugger, but I think it's important to be aware of the impact that we're having on the environment.
What you do today matters in the future.
It can only have this much impact, but if a lot of people have that much impact, we can make a big difference.